It is a huge blow to the Big 12 conference, but a huge opportunity for the universities of Texas and Oklahoma if they leave the conference. Good morning to Shehan Jayaraja, the college insider for Texas Football Magazine. UT and OU, presumably, to the SEC. Let's first, who are the winners? And it's not just those two schools.
No question. I mean, I think the SEC as a whole is set to make a whole lot more money. Certainly, they were already going ahead further than the rest of the other conferences, but the SEC kind of becomes the first super conference in a lot of ways. You know, obviously having brands like Texas and Oklahoma added to the Alabamas, the Georgias, the Floridas of the world, they're set to make a whole lot more money. And certainly for ESPN, for the college football playoff, getting all of those brands under one roof, I think is going to be a real big boon for them heading forward.
And for the two schools as well, who are likely would make a lot more money off of the TV rights and the prestige and so forth.
Yeah, no question about it. I think that the reason that Texas and Oklahoma are looking to the SEC is because the SEC is safer waters right now. Their payouts are much bigger. And with these schools coming in, they're going to be real assets. And it's going to potentially take these two schools to another level financially. And they're already kind of lapping the field.
Who are the losers? Obviously, the Big 12, which is going to be down to eight teams, half the size of what the SEC would be.
Right. I think that the Big 12 is in a really precarious position right now with those other eight schools. I think a lot of them are going to look to see whether other major conferences will take them, whether the Big 10 or the Pac-12 especially. I think we'll look at those other schools. But if not, I think that certainly those eight schools are in a position where they could potentially fall out of those major power conferences, and that would really impact them financially. The Big 12 last year paid out about $34.5 million. And for comparison, the American Athletic Conference, where SMU and Houston play, paid out only about $7 million. So this could be a real impact. One of the other potential losers is Texas A&M, because they've kind of made their pitch over the last several years as, hey, listen, if you want to play in the Southeastern Conference and stay in the state of Texas, you can do it at Texas A&M. And certainly I think that Texas and Oklahoma coming into the league makes it a little bit more difficult.
So for recruits, what is the draw? I guess the easy answer is Alabama. What is the draw of a recruit from Texas or Oklahoma to play in an SEC school instead of what is already a very prestigious program, Texas or Oklahoma?
Listen, I think that it's very simply, they want to play on the biggest stage and they want to play in the NFL. And you look at the last 10 years, ever since Texas A&M and all those other schools left the Big 12, and the Big 12 has been lagging behind in terms of putting players into the NFL and competing for national championships. The last time that a Texas school played in the national championship game was back in 2009, when obviously Colt McCoy got hurt and they lost to Alabama. So listen, they want to play on the biggest stage. They want to be a first-round NFL draft pick. They want to play in the NFL. And while Texas and Oklahoma have done a very good job of doing that, they haven't done as good a job as the SEC has.
All right. It's going to be fascinating to watch. One of your colleagues in the sports business likened the Big 12 and Texas and OU to now an estranged couple living together in a one-bedroom apartment for the next couple of years. We'll have to see. Shehan, thanks very much for joining us from Texas Football Magazine.